Hello friends, when two solids intersect or penetrate, their surfaces intersect at a common line of intersection. We must know the exact location of the intersecting line for the development of the solids. The line of intersection, also known as the transition line, it could be of any shape. It would be a straight line when solids having flat surfaces intersect. The line could be a curved line when solids having curved surfaces intersect. Or it could be a combination of straight and curved lines when one of the intersecting solids is flat and the other one is curved. How can we obtain the two representation of the line of intersection? For that, first identify key points on the surfaces of the intersecting solids. Then, draw a number of lines known as generators from key points to plot the line of intersection. We have two methods to obtain the line of intersections. One of them is the line or generator method, and the other is the cutting plane or circle method. Let us look at the line method. Here, generators are drawn on the lateral surface of one of the solids. The points where these generators intersect are marked on the surface of the other solid. Then, the line of intersection is obtained by joining these points in a sequence. In the cutting plane method, a number of cutting planes are assumed to cut both the solids in the area of intersection. The position of the cutting plane may differ with the reference to the plane of projections. Points are marked on the surfaces of the solids where these planes cut. The line of intersection is obtained by joining these points in a sequence. Now let us solve one example to understand things better. A vertical square prism is resting on the HP with its faces equally inclined to the VP. It is completely penetrated by a horizontal cylinder such that their axes intersect at their mid-length. The axis of the horizontal cylinder is parallel to the VP. Now let us draw the orthogonal views first. As we can see, the top view of the vertical prism is a square with its sides inclined at 45 degrees to the VP. So draw the top view and project it to obtain the front view, which is a rectangle of height 140 mm. Now by projecting all the details from the top and front views, we get the side view. This will again be a rectangle with height 140 mm. We get the true shape of the piercing cylinder in the side view. Draw a circle of diameter 80 mm such that its center coincides with the mid-height point of the vertical prism axis. Then divide this circle into 8 equal parts. Project these points onto the top view, cutting the sides of the prism. So from the top view, project vertical lines from the intersecting points onto the front view to meet the horizontal lines drawn from the side view. Finally, let's join the obtained points on the front view in the proper sequence. Observe the curved lines as lines of intersection on the left and right end. Here we can see that both the visible and invisible curves coincide, giving us the solution. We shall see more cases of intersections of solids in the next session.